Jim's program, you are learning how to learn.
Well, every person is different. Some people are here for test-taking ability. Some people are here to work on their science background. And what I like about Jim's is that it is designed specifically for each person.
I learned that you need a structure, how you integrate material into your memory.
In undergrad, where I would just, you know, skim my notes and read passively, I went more to like putting, you know, information on the board, speaking it out to existence.
You are a student who has the privilege to take a course with a medical student to see if you can handle not only the rigor of that information, but also the pace of how you must assimilate it, integrate it, and apply it for a future clinical context.
I learned how to pick what's most important out of the massive amount of information that we're thrown.
Because anyone can memorize and that can, you know, disappear.
Conceptualizing those ideas that you're taught in class and being able to teach them to yourself as well as to someone else.
Before coming to GEMS, I was an undergrad at Howard. So I was pre-med biology major, and I was so excited about going to medical school, but unfortunately that didn't work out the first time.
I came to US in 2009 from refugee camp. After my graduation, I worked with refugees.
I was actually an amateur skateboarder before I came here.
I worked for a very long time in higher ed. I wasn't the type to come straight out of college into med school, and I think that that background has let me be a little bit more mature.
So many times I talk about cookie cutter advising, which means, well, you should take very good notes and you must go to class and ask questions. All students should do that. I want to understand, what is your specific way in which you prepare for your lecture? What resource do you use? Do you look at problem sets that have case-based scenarios and then you have to figure out the puzzle of the basic science? That's what we require you to do in GEMS. And the advising looks at your individual strategies for doing that.
Instead of writing a bunch of notes, I draw pictures. And being in GEMS, you actually conceptualize a lot during our FS or facilitated sessions, and that gives me an opportunity to hone my drawing skills but also to practice conceptualizing scientifically difficult concepts.
I found out that our GEMS program was more focused on helping you to know yourself.
The advising specifically with Dean Taylor and Dr. Kayengo, they've been great in helping to identify strengths and as well as weaknesses both in our application process, our academic skills, and even our personality.
With GEMS, we take what is known as a high-risk student population. The high-risk comes in the context of their academic backgrounds and also their social backgrounds. GEMS has been running for the last 40 years, and every year we have students who are admitted into the School of Medicine.
Growing up in the Philippines, I was surrounded by multiple people that lacked health insurance, and I think that is something that, you know, it's one of the driving factors that wants me to contribute to a community, especially to those that are living in underserved communities.
My career goal is to be a psychiatrist and work with immigrants and refugee population.
I'm going to be dean of a med school. I think GEMS is going to get me there because it's allowing me to build my interpersonal relationships. It's allowing me to kind of see how people act in a professional degree program. It's actually polished me a lot being here in GEMS, like just the presenting in front of people, speaking in front of people. And Dean Taylor really makes you rise to a higher level.
GEMS means representation.
Personal growth.
Becoming a woman of intent.
Diligence. Humility and confidence.